right, folks, welcome back. Chris Garlock here with Michael Redmond at game 41. We're into our last 20 games. We're just making amazing progress in these. These, of course, are the series of games that AlphaGo, the master version, played against a whole slew of top players in late 2016, early 2017. And we are doing a series of brief commentaries for your enjoyment and also for our own research for volume two of AlphaGo to Zero. So everybody wins and we get to have some fun. Today, I think we have a new player.
Yes, a new player for this series. Common name, actually, well-known. Kim Jiseok, a Korean player. One of the top Korean players. So he was born in 1989. So he's in his 20s still. But he's a two-time world champion.
Mm-hmm.
So a well-known name in Go players, among the Go players, that is.
Let's see how he does.
He's going to have the black stones. So this is one of the games where the human player makes the big moyo. And we're going to see AlphaGo sort of breaking the rules again.
Oh, goody.
So he plays the big tsumari. I sort of get the feeling that the players have picked up on AlphaGo's openings here.
Mm-hmm.
And they're trying out the bigger moves because this was never played before AlphaGo. It was, mm-hmm. Well, that's an exaggeration, of course. Like, there were a couple of players, two or three players. I know in Japan there was Oman, who is from Taiwan. He's one of the top players in Japan, and he liked to play this sometimes. But he said himself that he generally messed up immediately after he played this move. Because it is a relatively difficult move to make, because the corner here is not, it's relatively difficult to make, turn that into a black territory. It's not mm-hmm. established so easily. And so you have to use it towards the outside also. And how you go about that can be a bit complicated. AlphaGo plays a Kakari here. And black plays this pincer, which was very popular at the time. And we have the idea that when black has this big framework with the big tsumari there, black should be trying to make a framework about it. So the idea is that black should gain by making a big area where black controls it, making a moyo. So that was the way humans thought about it. But, you know, computer programs just say you have to play the attachment underneath. So this is a basic joseki. It makes it easy for people to learn josekis, actually, because there's not so many variations. And white will play something like this. We used to think that this was not so good for black because white was reducing the potential of this tsumari towards the right. But computer programs really like it because black has sente. Black can continue with something like A and B. Black just has the initiative in this game. And later on, black is going to try to attack this white group also with, for instance, moves like this, for instance. Sometimes black can play here on the second line, or black can play from the tsumari, for instance, a move like this, taking away white space to start with. There is some potential for black to be attacking later. So this is how the computers would have us play. But it was sort of counterintuitive to be playing this move when black has that big tsumari on the left. So black played here. White plays here. And this is like sort of old style joseki. But this variation, this whole variation just goes downhill for black very quickly. And it's something that was, white's going to play moves that sort of break the rules. They're almost taboo-like moves that we had studied. And we had decided that they were just bad before AlphaGo came. And then when AlphaGo played them, it was winning so easily, we had to change our minds.
Oh, wow. So
first of all, to show you what black was supposed to play was this move. This is a move that was not, it was existent. It was in play already. Sometimes people would play it when they didn't want to get into that other joseki. And this is the better way for black to play. White has to cover on top, so black can crawl here. This kind of, obviously, I wouldn't think of jumping into 3-3 point here, but this is supposed to be the best variation for black, in which black is keeping a lead. although I remember that Katago did not like that move, I think Black still has more than 50% because Black does start with a slight advantage at 6.5 point koni. Instead, Black plays here. So this is a joseki where the game move was this one. We had some people experimenting with an attachment at the 3-3 point. There was a lot of research being done about this joseki, and human players in general, professionals at least, were very confident that we knew what we were doing here. It turns out AlphaGo wants Black to play here. In fact, this is the second game in which we've looked at this joseki. I forget the game number, but we did do it once before.
Mm-hmm.
It's suggesting this kind of thing.
Yeah, that's right.
Where Black takes territory, or even Black can connect here, which is really, really strange.
Yeah, nice shape, right?
Nice shape, but the cut is pretty severe. It turns into this trade where Black is going to finish off the white stones on the right. It is bad shape if we just look at this shape for Black, but the cut is a very effective cut. This cut is an effective cut. So it's closer to even than the game was, it turns out. No one knew that at the time. So I think I can forgive Black for playing this move. White bumps against, Black jumps. And the joseki that we had decided was correct was White plays here, then pushes. And then it depends on the ladder. So if White plays here, it looks like that Black stone, when Black plays here, it's gonna be a ladder breaking move. So we're talking about, just let me get a bit carried away here. Sorry, not that one. But the ladder, when Black plays here, this ladder is going to work. And so this was actually something that people had been researching, the fact that this move at six is going to be a ladder break that changes how White has to play the joseki. It was a kind of an opening trap, or you could say it was just research. It was supposed to be playable for Black because then White would have to continue with something like this, which was locally supposed to be okay for Black. This is also a joseki shape, but it's not as active as the move where White plays down to the second line. It's a bit of a compromise for White. So this was supposed to be okay for Black. So this is where a lot of research had gone into this, and this is where Black was headed. Turns out White just pushes through and captures this
stone.
And, you know, this is where we're saying you're not supposed to do that.
That's terrible.
That's supposed to be bad.
I actually know this joseki, and you're not supposed to do this at all.
You're not supposed to do that. Like, there were some players who tried it out, and everyone agreed that it was not good. That's not the case.
AlphaGo doesn't care.
This is, like, it's 60% for White. It's 40% for Black at this point, winning percentage.
60%.
And White, 60% for White. So Black has only 40% winning percentage at this point.
Oh, it's already looking bad. Good game a little while ago.
And there's this crazy move that White plays. This is actually good. So now...
White says, I don't care about your wall.
Yeah. So this is the game move. And White's going to bully that wall because White has this stone cutting here. White's going to make use of it. So just to go a few moves back, Black probably should play the hanging connection here. In which case, White will play here anyway. And it just gives Black that much more control over the right side. And it turns out Black shouldn't even bother with cutting here because White's alive in the corner anyway.
Right. Of course, yeah.
But this is all new stuff that we needed. We really needed to study this with AIs to get these ideas. We didn't have these. We just thought that this was just plain bad for White. And I'm pretty sure Kim Jiseok knew that AlphaGo had played this joseki once. And he was probably finding it hard to believe that this was actually bad for Black. Let's just watch what happens here. This is already really bad. Black has 37% winning percentage. so that's in the 60s for White. And it's supposed to be fairly close before Komi. So maybe Katago thinks maybe Black can win by 1 point before Komi. And White plays these moves. White's going to force Black to take that white stone. So like this. So White is saying just, you have to take this stone. Actually, this is where I'm going to stop my commentary for this. It's already very bad for black, as I was telling you.
Wow.
And it's sort of annoying for black that this moyo that black has in the center of the board that was more on the left side of the board, it's pretty much disappeared already. And so Kim Jiseok is going to get annoyed now. And it's going to make it pretty exciting in the way he plays it out. But it just didn't work anyway.
Well, we'll save that for the book. Yeah. But you know, this is the second time that, that AlphaGo has just thumbed its nose at a wall. And it just goes completely contrary to every... I mean, you know, it's like, here, I'm going to help you build the wall. And then I'm going to play... Well, he plays, what, four
right months? Next to it. You know, he's saying that black has to protect it. He's saying you have to take the net. And this would be so humiliating for black to have to play this move. It's white who is attacking the wall. And so the really amazing moves were these moves, very similar to the moves that white was playing in the previous game in which master played this joseki. These moves from the center that are forcing moves for white. And black did not actually submissively answer in this game. Black counterattacked with this, made a big fight, and it wasn't very successful for black, actually.
Surprise, surprise, surprise. All right, well, we'll talk about that when we do the commentary for the book. All right, folks, you should try this at home. It probably won't work out for you, but it'll be fun anyway, right, Michael?
It'll be fun. Just playing these moves that I've marked here would be a lot of fun.
Yeah, absolutely. All right, thank you, Michael. Thanks, everybody, for watching. See you next game.